Now that Gordon has passed our area and is moving north, parts of the coast are settling down. But it's the first couple of days after a storm that can pose the biggest threat. News 13's Peyton LoCicero takes us to the beach in Okaloosa County, where Gordon's outer bands are still being felt.
Double red flags are still flying in the wind, and rough surf is still pounding the shores.
The next day or so is not a good day to get in the water at all. Most of the beaches on Northwest Florida through the Gulf Coast are closed to swimmers and bathers.
The Gulf is churning and the sand is displaced, leaving the beach a dangerous place to be. There are strong rip currents and long stiff currents stretching down the shoreline.
The storm surge here wasn't really that significant, so it didn't pull a lot of sand off the beach.
Beach safety officials say they're pleased with how the beaches held up.
We didn't see any damage really from this storm. Meg's Drive right now in Shalimar is closed. It's a low-lying road from some localized flooding, but really we dodged a bullet on this one.
It's important to have a game plan. Now in the midst of hurricane season, there are two simple ways to be prepared. Create a hurricane plan with evacuation routes mapped out and supplies ready. Also, stay informed. You can download WMBB's free weather app at mypanhandle.com.
In a waterproof box, pack things like batteries, waters, sanitation products, a first aid kit, non-perishable items, and essential medications.
It should hopefully have the silver lining that we're able to tell people about what they need to do to get ready for a storm.
The countdown is on with 86 days left until hurricane season ends on November 30th. In Okaloosa County, I'm Peyton LoCicero, News 13.